And welcome everybody to a I don't even know what the heck this is actually to a short little video of me kind of testing things out and trying to gauge interest in a possible new series for me. So I got this idea. Oh gosh, my mouse feels sticky, like I'm all jerky. Am I jerky, you guys? What kind of jerky would I be if I was jerky? Would I be turkey jerky? I think I'm kind of a turkey jerky kind of guy, even though I actually dislike turkey jerky. I dislike all kinds of jerky. I know that's like blasphemy for some of you guys, but I am just not a jerky kind of guy. But my mouse is rather jerky today for some reason. I probably need to clean it off or something. So I should not be recording right now. My music is playing my neighbors. Yes, my neighbors are playing some rather loud, bass-heavy music. My daughter is crying. There's clinks and clanks from the kitchen because my son is eating his dinner. But I haven't put out a video today, and I wanted to just kind of put something out there. And this is something I've been wanting to do for a while. And yes, here we are. Here we are, you guys. We are at the top of a gigantic mountain and level 231. And guess what, you guys? Oh gosh, that's not what I want to do. Guess what, you guys? This is a mountain that I created myself. So I got this idea. And here's, you know what? Those of you who are like, what the heck is this, man? I don't want to just stop talking. I don't even want to see this or whatever. Just go play some CTM maps. I may include some footage of me like playing a really difficult map at the end without much commentary, just to try to satisfy those viewers who tune in. And now my neighbors are taking a shower, so you know, just listen to that, please, listen to that. But yeah, so those of you who don't care much about me or my channel, just want to see good CTM gameplay, you should probably turn it off now or skip to the end where I'm doing some fun stuff. But here's my idea. All right, I've been wanting to do a survival series for a while now, just a vanilla survival series type thing. But honestly, vanilla Minecraft is somewhat boring and repetitive for me. I mean, I can still hop on like a UHC world and have some fun, but for the most part, it's just gotten, it's the same old thing, same old thing. Once you have the iron, everything is good to go. So my idea is to kind of create my own custom world, and that's what this is, with scarce supplies, scarce resources. As you can see, this is the coarse dirt, which I'm pretty sure you can actually use a hoe on and turn it into farmable land, which I don't think I like. I've created a few of these worlds. Now I'm using the program World Painter, I think is what it's called. Yes, I'm very new. So those of you who are map makers, it's pretty ugly, all right? It's pretty ugly. There's a lot that I need to work on. And I know that I need to use some other programs in order to clean things up and kind of put my finishing touches on things and whatnot. But it's not just going to be a hostile environment. The idea behind it is what I call, although this, I don't know, I told my wife yesterday and she was just like, she kind of looked at me like, really? Like, that's your grand idea? I'm just like, sorry. That's all my brain can come up with. I'm sorry. But part of this was also inspired by Vex's really poor dungeon design on Super Hostile Online, where it was constantly max spawn. But that's kind of the idea, is it, I want to call it Dark World, all right? And of course this is not dark, right? Everything is lit up, there's glowstone everywhere. And that's kind of the idea, is that everything in the world is pre-lit, as opposed to being dark, which is how Minecraft usually is. And so mob spawns are spread out and all those kinds of things. But the idea is, essentially, instead of creating a world where the goal is to light things up to prevent mob spawns, I would be creating a world where the goal is to darken everything. So all of my bases, everything would be dark. I would still be using some minimal lighting in order to make things, good for you guys, so that it's just not like me sitting in a little hut in darkness or something like that. There goes my daughter. She's going off again. But like redstone torches and stuff like that, or just, you know, minimal lighting in order to encourage mob spawns. And yes, that means that like the bases that I build are going to have mobs spawning inside of them. So it's going to be kind of a constant adventure, a constant kind of struggle to fight and to create my dark world. That's the idea behind it, at least. Again, this is all very much in my, like, I was bored and I was thinking one day and I was like, what should I do? What should I do? And this is kind of what I came up with. I already made one of those. Do not need to make another one of those. Let's go ahead and make a sword, shall we? And let's go ahead and explore a little bit. And it would almost be like reverse constructing a CTM map kind of thing. Whereas in a CTM map, you're lighting up dungeons, I would kind of be creating dungeons in survival mode. I really do apologize for all the background noise. It's a little insane right now. And that's one of the reasons why I can't record a proper CTM video. And I'm guessing most people who are watching this are probably those people who are, you know, my core subscribers kind of thing. As you can see, one of the things that I've run into is issues with lag because of the how chaotic the world is. I think, yes, some really ugly stuff that I need to fix here. But this is, I think, my third attempt at a world, so I think I'm getting better at it. I think I am improving. And again, I haven't even experimented at all with like World Editor or any of those more like kind of fine-tuned editors. This is World Painter is good for creating these kind of large landscapes like this. But yeah, so that's my idea, to do a series, a survival series, where it would be kind of reverse construction of a CTM map. And that would be the series, is me building dungeons, me building stuff in survival mode, me playing around with like spawning mechanics, traps, you know, combat, all that kind of stuff. And I can essentially build my base and then play through it like it's a dungeon in a CTM map. That's my thinking behind this. I've never seen a series like this, so I feel like it's unique, but maybe there are series that are like that. I really like the idea of creating a kind of custom landscape for me to play on. And if I ever get more money, maybe I'll even open it up as a server for other people to play on as well. So, I don't know. I just wanted to share this idea with you guys to get some feedback, to see what you think. I think we have the most important things that we need, right? Let's go ahead and venture out. So, again, one of the problems that I've run into is simply lag, problems with water and lava as well. Resources are supposed to be very scarce in the map, so we don't have much in the way of food to start off with, although I did see some rabbits around earlier, so maybe we can find ourselves some rabbit food. And my idea is that spawn point would be on a giant mountain, and then surrounding the mountain would be this kind of void. Yes, rabbit, rabbit, come here, rabbit. I want to eat you. I want to eat your butt. Babies, give me your baby rabbits too. Oh, yes. Yes, indeed. Rob rabbit. I'm a frog all of a sudden. I hear another one. But this kind of stuff would be pretty rare throughout the map. Were there two? There's two, you guys. There's two. There are indeed two. Give me all the meat. Rabbit meat. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. There's no stone around here. There might be some down in the caves. Like, I can see some coal right there, and usually coal is a good indication that there's some stone around. But, you know, honestly, I had the hardest time. Ooh, look, it's a bone structure, you guys. I've never actually encountered those kind of in the wild, I guess you could say. What was I just saying? I have no idea. Oh, I played around with, like, different base blocks. Like, I thought about doing hardened green clay to kind of mimic grass, but I don't know, I didn't like the way that it looked, and so I thought the dirt would be good, but at the same time you can end up using the dirt for farmable land, which I really don't want there to be too much of. I want dirt to kind of be a resource that is scarce in and of itself, and so it would also encourage exploration, and it would lead to, I think, some pretty interesting just survival based gameplay is my idea. I also want to populate the areas with structures, or not anything too elaborate. You know, I want to do most of the building myself, but I wouldn't mind having just even some vanilla based structures. Right now I have a problem with far too many ocean monuments being spawned in, but beyond that, I don't know, even some ones that I custom build, or that you guys custom build could be included. I think that might be interesting. Things for me to kind of venture out and explore would be a lot of fun. But again, most of that I would like to do myself. It looks like rabbits are going to be the number one resource in this map, and I am getting those momentary kind of stuttering lag spikes. And I think a lot of it has to do with blocks that are updating. Come back, Mr. Rabbit. Come back, please. I need to eat the food, just so I can regen some health. I have 4 pieces of cobble. So I don't know. This is, I guess, also me venturing out into map making. Oh, you're in a hole, guy. It's not a good place to be with me. When you're in a hole, you will die. And just trying to... And you can see there are trees. There are trees. There are resources in the map. But they're supposed to be kind of hard to get and not very plentiful. So that I have to be very creative about how I use them and how I get them. And yes, there is void, too. Again, like I said, I want the kind of central area to be surrounded by void. And I don't know, another thing that I think, oh gosh, yep, there's the ocean monument. So another thing is that this will also, I think, lead to some rather interesting opportunities for me to just play around with Minecraft mechanics and kind of test things out. So I don't know, this is my idea, this is the landscape that I have created thus far. Oh gosh, I got mining fatigue now, huh? Yep, yes indeed. And they're gonna start attacking me, and I'm gonna fall into the void, and we're all gonna die, and that should make for some good videos. So that's good, right? That is good. Anyways, this is a short video. I don't know what I'll include at the end. Maybe just a brief foray into, I feel like recording some legendary, so I think I might go and load up that map and play it out. But anyways, let me know what your thoughts are, especially those of you who are map makers. If you have any tips for me, things that I might try out, schematics that I can use, you know, anything that you think I might find helpful, would be much, much appreciated. But yeah, I want to bring a survival-based series to my channel. I haven't had one in a while, and I feel like this is a good direction to go. I think, oh, you freaking guy, you. I feel like there are far too many just regular vanilla-based stuff, and I'm even thinking about including, there's like a vanilla plus mod or something like that. I forget what it's called. I think the Hermitcraft guys use it. But maybe even including stuff like that to kind of slightly alter the original game. Why am I even doing that? There's no way I'm going to get through that. Just to slightly alter the game to make for some more interesting situations. So, anyways, go ahead and enjoy me playing the starting area of Legendary.